So I'm going to build a deck off the side of this house. It's going to be 5 meters wide and 6 meters long, and it's going to be a pretty simple design. It's just going to be a row of piers, or two rows of piers, one near the house, one at the end of the deck. Bearers on top of the piers, then our joists, and flooring on top. But what I want to know at the moment is, can I get a joist that's going to run this distance, which is 5 meters? So the things we need to know is the span we need, so again 5 meters, and we also need to know how far apart each joist is going to be. So I'm going to work with a 300mm center to center spacing for these joists. So knowing the span and the spacing, I'm now going to go and use Hyne Timber Design 7.5 to work out the actual size of the joists that we need. In order to download Hyne Design 7, all you need to do is type hyne.com.au into your address bar, and that'll take you straight to the Hyne website. Scroll down to the Hyne Design software, click on Get Hyne Timber Design 7, scroll down to the download area, click on Download Now, and your download will start. So once you've downloaded and installed the software, you'll find the shortcut on your desktop, and you can just double click on that to open up the software. Now, if it's your first time coming into the software, you'll be asked to register, but once you've been through the registration process, you'll find a screen that looks something like this. So we'll just go quickly through the screen and explain it to you. Obviously all your file details are down the left hand side here. Across the top you have your project data. So this is a screen, if you're doing a large job, you can enter in your project details. Before what we're doing, we won't need to look at that. Your simple design, we'll have a look at that in a moment. That's where you go in and just work out individual members. Your product control, so you can actually limit the types or the number of products you're looking at in there. Span tables, we'll have a look at that as well. You can actually go in and see what spans different types of timber will do. You also have a bracing calculator and a tie down calculator. You have a link to the Hyne Assist website, a save button and an exit button here. And the other ones you really need to know about, if you go into the Help tab, you'll see you'll have your edit registration area, so you can go back and edit that information you put in when you registered. And you can go to your help file if you need any more assistance with the software. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to go to Simple Design, and we're going to have a look at we're going to make sure we've got joists and rafters selected. And we're going to make sure we've selected deck joist in this particular example. We're going to make sure we've selected our span, which is 5 metres, and you can just type that in, or you can go up and down until you get to 5 metres. And we're going to make sure that we've selected one span. You can do 2, 3, as many as you want, but in this case we're going to go for a single span. You can also enter cantilevers left and right on your job, and you can change the parameters just to do centerline spans if you want. Okay, but we're going to go with this setup. Of course, we've selected deck joist. This is already pre-filled, so we've got decking, no ceiling, floor live is balcony loads. We've preset our deck joisting at 300, but you could go whatever spacing you want. I'll show you the implications of that later. No bottom edge restraint. So down here we can clear our settings, and then we select the timber we want to use. So in this case I want to use Hyne T3 Green, MGP 10 and 12, and because it's outside I want to make sure I've selected H3 timber outside above ground. Once I've selected all those, I can then go to Design Deck Joist 1, and I'll get the results for those. If you've got no results, then there's no timber available. You may need to change your parameters. Just as an example, I'll take this spacing back to 450, and hit design again, and I only get one choice. Because we're putting the joist cluster together, we get a few more choices. Okay, so there's the three types of timber we can use. We can look at them a bit closer. I would sort them by money, which is this button over here. So it puts the cheapest timber at the top. And the other thing I would look at is the DL. And I would go for the smallest one. That'll give you the stiffest deck, the less deflection, less bounce in the deck. So I would be inclined to use 240 by 45 MGP 12, but that's totally up to you. So that's the way we can use the simple design. Now the other option is we can use span tables. So if you go to span tables, again, make sure we've selected joists and deck joists. Down the right hand side here, we want to make sure we select our timber types. So I'm going to go T3 green, MGP 10 and 12. I only want to look at a single span example. And that's pretty much all the information I need to know, and then I can run the table. So this will bring up a report which I can print. And if I go down to the span tables, I can find, here's all my different types and sizes of timber and the appropriate span at the joist spacing. So you can see there, my 240 by 45, I could actually span 5.3. So I could make my deck a little bit bigger at very little expense. Or if I wanted to stay within my 5 meters, I could go back to a 400 spacing, so I might save myself a joist. So that's the MGP 10 report, and if I scroll down further, I'll see the MGP 12. Okay, so if I wanted to go MGP 12, I could go to 5.6, or I could open up my spacing to 480 mil, and I could get a 5.1 wide deck. So there you go, that's how we use span tables and simple design in Hyne Design 7.5 for our deck joists. Remember, Hyne T3 Green is backed by an up to 25 year guarantee. And here are a few tips and requirements to ensure your deck joists last as long as possible.